Crohn's disease is one of two chronic inflammatory bowel diseases. Usually the immune system helps you fight off infections. In inflammatory bowel disease, it attacks the digestive tract and causes inflammation. And what happens is that your body is unable to get rid of the bacteria and viruses that are helping with the inflammation. Basically, your immune system never turns off. And because it doesn't turn off, you perpetuate inflammation in the gut and form ulcerations in the gut. The chronic inflammation is what leads to symptoms in Crohn's disease. The most common presenting symptoms are abdominal pain and diarrhea. Other symptoms that patients may get is weight loss, appetite loss, fevers, chills, fatigue, anemia. Crohn's disease can also manifest in other parts of the body. Symptoms that can occur in other organs include joint pains, joint stiffness, eye pain, eye redness, skin lesions. People can get mouth ulcers as well as liver problems. Crohn's disease primarily affects people in their 20s and again in their 50s. It affects nearly 1 to 2 million Americans in the United States, and there's 10,000 new cases per year. Many of the patients have a family history of Crohn's disease, or they may have a family history of other autoimmune diseases. There are also environmental factors involved with the development of Crohn's disease, and those include infections, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications such as ibuprofen, stress, antibiotics. And so some of these things we can control, which may prevent triggering of the disease. We're able to make an accurate diagnosis with the history and physical exam, endoscopy with biopsies, lab tests, and imaging tests. There are three clinical patterns of Crohn's disease: inflammatory, stricturing, fistulizing disease, and microperforations. Treatment options for Crohn's disease fall in three basic categories: anti-inflammatory medications, immunomodulating medications, and then we have the neurobiologic agents. Steroids are very effective and work very quickly, but of course it does come with side effects. Surgery may be effective and necessary in some cases. The problem is that Crohn's disease can come back. It is appropriate in certain situations, especially if you develop a complication. It's important for doctors to individualize their treatment for each patient, and our Stanford Inflammatory Bowel Disease Program does that. We have goals in management, and those are to get people in remission quickly, maintain them in steroid-free remission, avoid complications, hospitalizations, and improve their overall quality of life. Having a multidisciplinary approach to this complex disease is very important. We involve our dedicated gastroenterologist, colorectal surgeons, pathologists, radiologists, dermatologists, dietitians, as well as rheumatologists to help get the best care to our patients. Additionally, we collaborate very closely with basic scientists so that we can bring newer therapies to the bedside. It would be great in the future if we would be able to target therapies to certain parts of the gut, also be able to predict who's going to respond to which therapy so we don't use time, money, and the patient's quality of life is wasted on these sort of things. We are doing some of that research at Stanford, and we're hoping to develop newer therapies that are safer as well.